What's up, guys? It is me, Sai, your anime protagonist VTuber, here with my Yu-Gi-Oh! Compilation for this week. Anyway, I'm not just for this week. These are a bunch of Yu-Gi-Oh! Compilations. So basically, the Duelist Cup first stage is over. I didn't make it. I did not make it to the second stage because, you know, I'm using a low tier deck. I could have made it if I have another account. I could have made it with an Eldritch deck or Adventure Prank Kids deck, but in my streaming account, I'm not using those type of deck. I prefer to like archetype lock myself as a challenge, but you know, since you're not using a high chance deck, it's hard to have like 5 wins in a row, so I never made it to like max. So, but I really did made it high with a Dragon Maid deck, a modified Dragon Maid deck. I actually tried to modify the Dragon Maid, mixed in a few kaijus in it, so it actually made me far. But you know, when you lose the toss coin against a Sword Soul user, you're dead. Like, I could still like combo it depending, but if they were able to summon like a 3 negate or 4 negate board, it's dead. But yeah, I still have great games though. I found a lot of creative decks. It's actually refreshing though, even though the Duelist Cup is like a very competitive event. We still find people like using decks that they like, or not decks that are not that strong. And here are a couple of the compilations of the best plays I have seen, the best games I had, games that I really did enjoy. So here's a compilation of my Dragon Maid deck, deck again during the Duelist Cup. Hope you guys enjoy.
since we're still on the topic of extreme opinions, mistake number two is not to waste your chips right away. This type of mistake to avoid is going to be like a long-term investment. Right now, you're trying to use it to max out your level for the day, and I'm more than sure, later on in the late game, especially if you come from Genshin Impact, it was super hard to level up after like AR-55 or even AR-50. But right here in this game, when you're going to be experience hungry, these chips are finally going to come in handy. So try not to spend them right now, or for today. Yes, you can do it. It's at your discretion, but it's just a mistake to avoid. Mistake number three, and this is for you F2Pers out there. Calling all the F2Pers. Free to play. Don't want to spend a single dime on this game. Do not waste your dark crystals on the standard dungeon. Seems a little obvious, but when you start off the game, you're so excited and you're like, oh my gosh, we have a soft pity at 30. I just need 10 more. I just need 2 more. I'm going to use my dark crystals and get it. I know it can be tempting, but don't do it. I already did it. I already made a mistake. But if you're just starting a game and you've seen this video, try not to make that mistake. What you need to spend your dark crystals on is the limited time bomb. Because with standard wishes, you can farm them throughout the whole map, and you can, you know, get more as you explore the map and get it as common rewards. So you don't need to spend your dark crystals on that. You need to get some of these golden necklaces. And this is a mistake that a lot of people make, especially starting off in the game, because they're just like really hungry for the SSR. Mistake number four, and this is gonna be found whenever you're doing your dailies. I've already said this in my previous beginner guides video, is you wanna unlock your dailies as soon as possible, because it's gonna get you access to nuclei and a lot of experience points. And the game tells you to, you know, track them down, but what the game doesn't tell you, and this is where the mistake comes in, is to claim your bounty reward. Bounty missions refreshed by the clock just right here. It's gonna be a symbol right here, and it's gonna be for you to claim it. The game doesn't outright tell you, hey dude, look over here, claim your bounty reward. Don't forget, we're not gonna tell you, but just do it. But I'm here to tell you to claim it. Mistake number five is to not spread yourself out too thin. Don't level up every weapon you get. If you're one of those freaking people that are like, oh my gosh, Hydro Sam, I got freaking 10 SSRs before my level 80 kitty. Okay, good for you. But don't level up every SSR. And I know you want to know what are the good SSRs, and I'm working on that video, guys. So don't forget, if you want to get notified for that video, like the video, subscribe to the channel if you want more Power Fantasy videos. I appreciate the support on my beginner's guide. But before I do more marketing and advertising, what I was saying is do not spread yourself out too thin. You're gonna get a lot of materials in the beginning, and this is with every gacha game. They give you a lot in the beginning so that we can go freaking spend crazy on it. But then later on in the late game, you're gonna have to farm for it, use your stamina, do all that good stuff, and just you're gonna be struggling at the end to max out your weapons. How are you? I'll just like get 3. Focus on those weapons and get 3 that you have fun with, because I have like King and some other characters. I have this guy, whatever. And you know what? I'm like, you know, I know King is super good. He's super good. But I'm like, I have more fun with Shiro, you know? Shiro. Look at my girl Shiro. Like, she just, I don't know, like her aesthetics is just really good. And of course, also my girl Tsubasa. Okay. And so recently I've decided, and then I did this whenever I played Genshin Impact, why follow the meta? Have fun. Level up the weapons you enjoy the most. And that is a mistake I want to avoid. And this mistake also transitions to matrices. Don't get too worked up over matrices. You're gonna get better ones later on. I feel like it's the same thing as artifacts in Genshin Impact. Like, yes, in the beginning, you know, whatever, they kind of suck, and you want to level them up, but you just don't know better. But I think it's worth it to wait for those SSRs and have all of these ready to go. You can feed them into your future SSR chips. But don't stress about this one too much. I feel like you could level up some and complete like a 3-3 bonus set that gives extra damage towards your like main DPS weapon. And of course, you can always feed these later on to your future SSR matrices. And while I am on the topic of upgrading materials and not spreading yourself out too thin, these boxes right here, leave them in their boxes. Don't use them. Don't be like, okay, I'm just gonna get like all of these. No. Just leave them in their boxes. The thing about these games is whenever you upgrade your weapons, they give you the option to just like use a ragdoll in there in order for the upgrade. So you never know what new SSR you're gonna get and what weapon you're gonna like and what.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, I guess that's it. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the deck. What kind of decks do you guys use on Yu-Gi-Oh! Master Duel? Are you Meta Sheep? I know, like, Meta Sheep is an insult, but to me it's not really an insult. I just call you guys. If you guys want to have fun by copying others and just enjoying the win, good for you. Okay. But yeah, what kind of decks do you use? Do you have any creative decks that you use on casual duels? Have you made it to the second stage using the deck you love? Leave it in the comments below. So anyway, have a great day, guys. See you guys in the next compilation. You can check out my Yu-Gi-Oh! Playlist right here. See you guys again. Have a great day. Goodbye.